First, let's go to Filter, and open the Camera Raw filter, and modify the values that we see on the screen. Then with the Object Selection tool and the Quick Selection tool, we select the subject. After selecting the subject, we apply a layer mask. We also create a new layer and put it under the subject layer. Fill it with a red color to see the edges of the subject, and with the brush tool we refine its edges. Then we go to Image, and click on Destar to remove the color from the image. Now with the Crop tool, we enlarge the image and fill the background layer with a gray color. Now we go to the other image. Using Ctrl plus the C key, we copy it, and then paste with Ctrl plus the V key in the image we are working on. Then we adjust the image in the center of the subject, lowering the opacity to see better. Then keeping the Ctrl key pressed, we click on the subject layer mask to get its selection, and we apply a layer mask on the other image. Now with the help of the brush we eliminate some areas as seen on the screen. With a white brush we reveal the area of the subject on the floor since we want it to look complete. Then having the Ctrl key pressed, we click on the layer of the main subject to obtain its selection again and invert it. In this part we can invert the selection as much as we want. Take your time with the brush so that the result is optimal. Then we go to Image, Adjustment, and click on Hue Saturation to lower the saturation of the image. Now we make the background layer invisible, and we press the Ctrl, Shift, Alt and E keys to create a layer with all the layers together. Then we apply a clipping mask on the layer that we create and remove with the brush the lower part as seen on the screen. Once this is done, we open the camera raw filter and modify the values that are seen on the screen. Then with the dodge and burn tool, we apply light and shadow in some areas manually. Now we create a new project with the measurements shown on the screen and paste the layer where we were working. Here we apply a gray background again, and with the text tool, we create a text with the name of Muhammad. By double-clicking, we open the effect options. Here we apply a gradient effect as seen on screen. After applying the effect, we rasterize the text, then we double click again and apply a pattern effect. Now we create another text, changing the font, we write the name of Ali. We adjust the size, change the color if we want and place it next to the other text. We rasterize the text and double-click to open the effects, and apply a bevel and emboss effect, and then apply a shadow effect. We also apply a shadow effect to the text Muhammad. Then with the control key pressed, we click on the largest text to obtain its selection, and with the eraser tool we delete some parts of the text there as seen on the screen. Perfect, we're done. If you liked this video, do not forget to subscribe, leave your like and share. Thanks for the support.